What is going on, guys? This is Kane here, and I'm filming pilot tutorial for Transport Tycoon, both passenger and cargo. So I'm gonna start you off by showing you how to switch jobs. If you look in the top right-hand corner, you'll see where the money is and your job. Mine's currently set to pilot, because that is what I will be doing. But to switch, you'd come on here, we'll do an example like, say, farmer. It'll change to farmer right away. But for pilot, you'd have to choose pilot, of course. So you want to go down and find that. It will be right here. And now, we will go to the airport. To cut the time, that way you don't have to watch the entire travel to the airport, I will be cutting the travel time until we get close enough to the airport. Alrighty, now that we've reached the airport, I am lagging a little bit, don't mind that, but now that we've reached the airport, I'm going to show you how to purchase a plane. See this here? This is to spawn a phantom truck. This is not where you get the plane. You go over here, make sure, if you look on the mini-map, you make sure you're like right close up to it or on top of it. That is the only way for the prompt to appear, like so. As you'll see here, where it says aircraft shop, you gotta select that, go down to your planes. This is the Vestra, the cheapest, for 20 grand. Here's the Vellum, and it looks like another player has decided to purchase something. Don't pay attention to them, because you can't see them. All you can see is their name. This is the Nimbus. This is what I will be using to show you passenger routes. We also have the Miljet. This is the start of the cargo planes, the DC-10. The cheapest of the cargo planes there are. After passenger, I will be showing cargo. Here is the EMB-390. Kinda looks like a whale. It's kinda screwed up on the textures in front, but if you zoom in, it looks a lot better. Here is the Osprey. I haven't decided if I'm gonna use the DC-10 or the Osprey to show cargo yet. But yeah. I'm not going to go down to the Beluga. It may be in the aircraft shop, but it's not in the game. If I were to select the Beluga, I would end up having to relog, and this whole thing would be screwed up. So I'm not going there. Alright, now that you've seen our planes, I'm gonna go spawn it and show you how to go through the jobs. So what you're gonna wanna do is find a blue garage logo here at the airport, because you cannot spawn these at any other garage. Even though it's available to do so, I don't allow it. Now, you're gonna go to get a vehicle as soon as you get the prompt. Go and look for your vehicle you want to use. I will be using the Nimbus, since that is the only passenger one I have. This is my Nimbus. I'm not gonna need a fuel up before taking off. Nimbus has quite a bit of lean. Pretty turning, if you notice. But it's all good. And because this is not a roleplay server, we don't have to worry about all the formalities or all the lines in the airport. Now, there's different pickups for passengers. These things can stop too fast. Here are tier 1 and tier 2 pickup. The one we're gonna be using. This one over here. The highest tier for passengers. Once the prompt appears, take the job, and now we will be going to every airport that there is here in the server. Before I take off, I will be going over runways. You hit the tab key, bring up the ATC menu. Looks like we got an Osprey coming in. We're at LSIA. These two long runways over here. If I can get the camera to focus right. This runway here, that is directly to my left, is 30R and 12 left. This one over here is 30 left, 12 right. But that's not, we're not going to be using any of those. Oh no. We're going to be using this one right here, 321. Select your takeoff of your runway, 321. There it appears on the screen right there in the chat box. Take off at 321 and away we go. As you can see, we are going to be flying in terrible conditions. Luckily, I've done this so many times, I know exactly where to go, pretty much. You can see these buildings right here. And for time's sake, I'm going to be cutting the video once again. I will be back as soon as we land, alright? See you then. Alright guys, and we are back. We are making our first landing at McKenzie. Throw on the land. Bring down the landing gear. Lag, it happens to me quite a bit. Oh god. Like I said, the lag does happen. Ideal. Stop showing that. Not my best landing, but hey, not everyone can land perfectly, right? Especially in GTA. If you want to land perfectly all the time, go check out Flight SimX Steam Edition. Alrighty, we have collected some vouchers. You also get money. Vouchers will vary between 1 and 3. don't worry about those passengers. Okay, well, screw you too, then, you stupid obstacle. Take you down. Alrighty, our next stop will be Palito Bay. No, that is not an official GTA airport. That is just one that was custom made for this server only. So, back up. Hit the tab button. Lag like hell. That's optional. Go down to McKenzie and take off. Once it appears on the screen, you may take off. And then you're up in the air. Once again, I'll be cutting out travel time, so see you on the landing into Palito. Okay, and we are approaching Palito Bay. Select Palito Bay, land, gear down, brace for impact! I'm just kidding. Gotta have a little fun. Oh, shit. Yes, I got one coming in to land directly behind me. This is gonna end badly. He's going around. Alrighty, we have arrived at Palito Bay. Time to switch passengers and go to Sandy Shores. Who knows what else is gonna happen in this tutorial. You always gotta stop before you use your prompt. Sometimes they're so stubborn they'll just teleport out and appear quite literally right on top of your plane, like so. And of course I got two vouchers. As I said, it varies. That's what happens when you stay on top of a plane, dude. Maybe next time you'll learn your lesson. Or not, because the AI is stupid. Fuck you. Ah, fuck you too. Stupid AI. Okay. What I just did there, I checked to make sure that dude was doing his call-outs, because call-outs are mandatory. Alrighty, Palito Bay, take off. Rotate. You're up. And I will. We are approaching Palito. Okay, we are gonna try this again. Sandy Shores, land on the jetway. Jet runway, I should say. Uh-oh. Okay. How's that? Coming in to land on the jet runway. Kill. And touchdown. And lag once again. Don't play in the runway next time then, and that won't happen to you. Oh, you're still alive. Oh, yes, you are. Haven. We actually lined up here with Daytona. Hit our L1 button, which is my confirm button on my PS4 controller, because that is what I use. Just said. He told someone else. Well, there he is. Boom. That's what you get. Alrighty. Sandy Shores. I think this time we will take off from 26 points, which is right in front of me. Alrighty, we are making our approach to Zancudo. Gear down. We're gonna land on the main one. We're gonna lag again. Because it's like the best thing ever. A new program I installed. Slowdown.exe. This program is called Snail. Like I said, Lag City. I guess I never actually said that. Until now, at least. I completely overshot where I needed to turn. But yeah, Snail. Snail's pretty much what it's called. Snail.exe. Looks like it's working like a charm, too. Gotta have a little bit of fun when you're having stuff like this happen. Excuse you, Mr. AI. Now, if I went ahead and went in front of him, he would just plow straight into me without a care in the world. Practically everything that the passenger has to offer. I am going to see you all when I get back to LSIA for cargo. See you then. And we're back at LSIA. So now time to do cargo. Gotta get a vehicle. Just for the sake of planes, we're gonna use the DC-10. This is one of the liveries it spawns with. I will show you the different liveries with our livery changer. This one is livery 1. FedEx, livery 2. Martin Air is livery 3, which is Martin Air Holland. I will be doing FedEx, as that is the one I prefer to use the most. Never really liked the other ones, to be honest. 8K, make that go away. You'll notice every time you spawn the DC-10, there's like a little over 50% or under 50%, so I always fuel up before I do a run when I first get on my DC-10. And going forward is kind of weird because you gotta go really slow, but you're fine when you're going backwards. So, to get fuel, roll up here is stop when the prompt appears. PS4 controller L1 or keyboard E. Take it on over to the highest it'll go and confirm. You'll see the little fuel thing shows that its percentage is increasing. It goes by percentage, not gallons or liters. Just by percentage. That's just how it was set up. Don't ask me why it goes to 100.2. I cannot answer that. But now that we got our fuel, it's time to get our cargo. Here, wait for it to appear. Once it appears on the left side of your screen, okay. Normally it's supposed to appear on the right side, but alrighty then. Get your boxes. Notification appears just like that. What you're gonna do is hit the M key, go into car options, access trunk, put. This is your inventory. So you're gonna go to cargo boxes. Then you're gonna put them in your. Just gotta do one at a time then. Once you're completely full, you'll pull out. I'm doing this for fun, Ken. This is a tutorial. Some people are crazy enough to take off from runway 3. I'm not one of those people. I take off from 30 left. Or, well, 30 right, I meant. Twelve left, 30 right. That is... yeah. Can be a little easy to mess them up when you're going down the taxiway. Once you get there, you're completely fine. Because of the snow, I do not fly over the ocean, so you'll get to see some weird maneuvers. Like a 90 degree upon takeoff. Because the last time, one in the snow was brought in. I tried flying over the ocean. I ended up in the water. So, hit the tab key, LSIA, take off. 30R, 12 left. And away we go. Zancudo. You can fly over the ocean if you want. I just prefer to go over Los Santos and fly by the mountains. And as I always say, to each their own. Because this plane is going so slow, I will be back with you when I'm approaching Zancudo. So, see you then. Alrighty, we are coming in to Zancudo. I am a little over, but that's correctable. So, tap key, Zancudo, land. Got runway lights inside here. Zancudo, we will taxi to the cargo delivery area. Don't want to go too fast. That would not be a good thing. And right here would be the cargo area. So, since I've shown you with the DC-10, I will also show you with the Osprey. That is the other plane I have. Alright, pull up into here, don't go too far, because then the prompt will disappear. Go back, it appears, boxes. You get rid of the two in your inventory. DM key, car options, trunk access, take, boxes, two. Do I have two? Yes, I do. And you see there, it gives you your strength, your piloting, and your player level skill. You also get airline vouchers and candy cane since this is the winter time. And it's the winter event for the server. If you're watching this in, like, any time not winter or around Christmas time, that's why. Holiday season only. I am only doing this because this is the way I take off from, because of the whole don't fly over the ocean thing. No one else is coming in for a landing. Clear shot back. See, it turns a lot, the turning is a lot more sharp, I guess. If sharp is even the right word to use when it comes to turning. Alright, tab key. Zancudo, takeoff. Let's get out of here. we are off, and I will see you before we get to Los Santos. Alrighty, we are coming into Los Santos at an angle. Gear down. I prefer to come in at 12 right. Gotta make sure I'm not too low, because right below me is the ocean, and I do not like flying over the ocean. So the whole Osprey thing isn't going to be happening, since I completely forgot that it's going to be removed, so we won't be using that in the video. So here we are coming in for landing. That is how I do my DC-10 work. Hope you like this tutorial. There are others that will be up, kind of like this. Not all of them will be in this type of way that I'm doing it, but there's other tutorials that will be coming up. So yeah. Server IP will be in the description if you are interested in anything. And hope to see you in game. So until next tutorial I make, see ya!